Hello friends, once again your favorite Dr. Swapnil Prabhulkar have come with the same tagline, simplicity at its best. Friends, I always come with new and new stuff on my channel so that you will enjoy the channel. Yes, I come with the scientific stuff, I come with the music, songs and so on. Today, I have come with the scientific stuff again. In one of our previous videos, we have seen about how the stability of a nucleus, a radioactive nucleus can be achieved. For that, we also have seen what is the role of neutron to proton ratio. And today we are going to see if we want to have that neutron to proton ratio near to one means what? So that our nucleus will be stable and the atom that we get will be the stable atom. Okay. So for this, the simplest thing would be that loss of neutrons. Is it so easy to lose neutron from the nucleus? No, friends. What is the reason behind that? Reason is neutrons are binded in the nucleus with tremendous amount of energy. That is around 8 million electron volts energy. Just imagine this 8 million electron volts energy is to be supplied to the nucleus so that we can remove neutrons from the nucleus so that neutron to proton ratio can be decreased to the towards the one or near to the value of one. So what is to be done? The another way around is we can have the beta emission. Yes, by beta emission we can achieve this neutron to proton ratio to be reduced to the value of or reduced to the value of one or near to the value of one. Okay, so that we can get a stable nucleus. Yes, what are we doing? We are going to get the radioactive nucleus. That radioactive nucleus is about to lose the neutrons to stabilize, or other way around, that radioactive nucleus must disintegrate in the form of loss of beta particles. Loss of beta particles means what? Loss of beta particles will lead to increase in atomic number, and as we are increasing the atomic number, what will happen? The number of protons will increase. Number of protons will increase means what? In the neutron to proton ratio, the value of denominator is going to increase. And this is how we can achieve the stability of radioactive nucleus to the stable nucleus. Let us see with an example how it exactly can be done. So what can we have here? That stability of atomic nucleus through neutron emission or beta particle emission. Right, so we can find that the easiest way, that if it is neutron emission, then how that neutron emission will lead to the stable nucleus. For example, we can take example of an radioactive element like krypton with atomic number 36 and atomic weight 87. Yes, which will lose neutron to give krypton of atomic number 36 with the atomic weight 86 with a loss of one neutron. Neutron doesn't have atomic number, so zero, it will have one mass, so one mass. So has it decreased the neutron to proton ratio? Let us see. 36 atomic number means what? It has 36 protons. So 86 minus 36 will give us the number of neutrons present. So just think of 6 minus 6, 0. 8 minus 3, 5. So it will become the neutron to proton ratio, that is N to P ratio. This is number of neutrons, this is number of protons, this is atomic weight. So N to P ratio will come to be N is 50 divided by 36. And it comes to be equal to 1.389. That means it is near to one. It is near to one, right? But what we have seen that it is not easy to remove neutrons from the nucleus. So the other path is what? See, this nucleus, that is krypton 36 with atomic weight 86, is a stable nucleus, right? which should give neutron, but it is not possible due to high binding energy of the neutrons. So our krypton 87 adopts a different route, and let us see what that route is. So friends, instead of going to the direct removal of neutrons, our krypton 87 undergoes beta emission. Yes, how does it occur? Let us see. Your krypton, which is having atomic weight 87 36, which is the radioactive nucleus. Yes, so what will be the neutron to proton ratio in this case? Just same thing, 87 minus 36. 87 is atomic weight, 36 is the number of protons, so we can get the number of neutrons by 7 minus 6 1, 8 minus 3 5 51. So n by p value for this krypton 87 comes to be equal to 51 divided by 36, and the answer comes to be 1.417. Yes, and which was the answer for this? This nucleus was little bit more stable than this nucleus, and the value was coming to be for this particular n by p value for this krypton is coming to be equal to 1.389. yes, because the number of protons found to be 36. So 86 minus 36, that will be the number of neutrons. Neutrons are 50 divided by 36, you get 1.389. so this is little bit more stable than this 1.417. so n by p value is definitely more than 1. So in next possibility, your krypton 87 undergoes beta emission, and due to this beta emission, I will write like this, you get the next nucleus. Beta emission means what? It is increase in atomic number. So as one beta particle is removed, the atomic number will become 37, and 37 is the atomic number of rubidium. And the atomic weight will remain same, 87, because we are increasing only the atomic number, so it will remain same. Now let us find out what will be the n by p value for this. We are taking that atomic weight for this particular species as 87. Yes, and number of protons will be now 37. So minus 37. So it will give us the value of number of neutrons. 7 minus 7 0, value of neutrons will become 50. Now this is the number of neutrons, 37 is the number of protons. So n by p value for this rubidium 87 will be 50 divided by 37, and it comes to be equal to 1.3514. okay, now still we can see that if this rubidium undergoes disintegration, still this rubidium is not that much stable, so it will again undergo a beta emission. I would say minus beta emission, and it will give an increase in atomic number, say 38, and this is the atomic number of strontium, which has atomic weight around 87. Yes, the stable atomic weight of strontium can be 87.6. Here we can take this as 87 for our strontium. Now let us find out what will be the neutron to proton ratio for this strontium 87. Okay, same thing we are going to apply over here. We are going to find out the number of neutrons present. We know the number of protons present are 38, and let us find out n by p value to find out the ratio. So how can we do that? We have atomic weight 87, minus number of protons, that is 38, which will give us the number of neutrons which are present, and that comes to be equal to 49. Now this 49 is the number of neutrons. So what will be the neutron to proton ratio? That is equal to 49 divided by 38. And let us see, this value comes to be equal to 1.289. Now friends, find out the comparison. Just compare the first value of the krypton 87, that is 1.417. If it is undergoing the neutron emission, it will be 1.389. If it is goes first emission to find out to form rubidium, which is also radioactive rubidium, which is having atomic weight 87, so it is having 1.3514 value. And it goes to strontium 87, which is the stablest form, and that is giving the neutron to proton value of 1.289, which is the lowest value of n by p found in both, in all of these observations. And therefore we can conclude here that this krypton 87, instead of going through direct loss of neutrons, it gives the step-by-step loss of beta particles to disintegrate into a stable strontium nucleus. So friends, now you must have understood that why exactly the direct neutron emission is not possible, or rather it will give some more unstable nucleus than that is expected one, and why the beta emission in given reaction or given nuclear reaction is more feasible to give you the stablest nucleus of the atom, that is the krypton 87 to we have got the strontium 87. Okay, so friends, if you have liked the video, hit that like button, share the video to all. If you haven't subscribed the channel yet, subscribe channel immediately, hit that bell icon so that whenever I'll publish new video, you will immediately get the notification that Dr. Swapnil Pragulkar have published a new video, and you will be the first to watch that video. So friends, we'll see you again in the next video.